Today's research and engineering activities often require precise measurements of electrical signals. While large signals are easy to measure, small signals buried in noise can be real challenges. This is where the right measurement technique makes a big difference. Hi, I'm Heidi, and in this video, you will learn about the working principles and advantages of boxcar averagers. In many applications, for instance, pump probe spectroscopy, short periodic pulses carry the information. Intuitively, it is beneficial to capture the signal only during the duration of the pulses and discard the noise in between. And that's exactly what a boxcar averager does. It captures the signal during a well-defined temporal window that matches the pulse's duration and position. The signal is integrated inside the boxcar window and ignored outside of it. To increase the signal-to-noise ratio, the result can be averaged over many periods. Consequently, the two main measurement parameters are the boxcar window width and the number of averaging periods. Let's take a Gaussian pulse as an example and look at how these parameters affect the measurement performance. The captured signal increases with the window width until the full pulse is covered. But a larger boxcar window also measures more noise, which increases proportionally to the square root of the window width for white noise. Consequently, there is an optimum window width. The moving average over multiple periods improves the signal-to-noise ratio, since the captured signal increases linearly, while the captured noise increases only with the square root of the number of periods. However, the choice of the number of averaging periods directly affects the temporal response. After a step in the signal, the resulting value approaches the final value linearly and settles after n periods. Hence, the best choice is a trade-off between signal-to-noise ratio and measurement speed. So far, we have seen that boxcar averaging can be easily understood in the time domain. In the frequency domain, the boxcar function can be described by a sum of cosine terms, corresponding to the harmonics of the repetition rate. The boxcar averager captures the signal on these frequencies and efficiently rejects other frequency components. The weighting of the individual terms is a sinc function. Its width is inversely proportional to the duty cycle. The smaller the duty cycle, the more harmonics contribute to the signal. This response function matches the signal content of pulsed signals. The information is distributed in the frequency domain and is very effectively captured by the boxcar averager. As this filter function also captures the DC component of the signal, we can subtract it from the boxcar result by adding another window shifted in time. The use of such a reference window makes the measurement insensitive to DC offsets and slowly fluctuating noise floors. Let me summarize. The boxcar averager is a rectangular window function in the time domain defined by the boxcar window width. Its spectral response corresponds to the sum of the repetition rate and its harmonics, with a sinc function as an envelope. The result of the averaging settles after exactly n periods. I hope this video provided a good understanding of boxcar averages and perhaps some inspiration for their use in your experiments. For more detailed information, please check out our white paper and contact us directly to discuss your application. Thanks for watching.